Hello everybody. Time again to try yet another classic salmon fly. So today we're gonna do Rosy Dawn, a lovely pattern. I'm gonna follow it from the Price Tennant book. And I'm gonna tie on a Graham Cully hook today, 5-0, in the shape I like. Maybe you don't like it, I don't know. But it's a nice hook. So let's begin. So, time to start. First of all, oval gold tinsel. I have extra thread. I'm just going to tie it in. There we are. Whole length. So I'm just waxing the thread again. So let's work with this tinsel. Just gonna tilt the hook so I see where I am. Just gonna have a check. Looks okay. Somewhere there. Going back with the thread then. And tying the tinsel in halfway forward to the middle somewhere. And then I'm gonna have plenty of tinsel to reuse for another time. So I'm just gonna build up a small foundation as always before adding the tail. Tail, and then we're gonna add tippet. Just fixing the trim. prepare the tail. So let's add that one. There we are. So I'm just gonna go make it a bit lower. And there is a fiber that I need to remove. Ow. I broke it. Okay, no worries. So I'm just gonna remove the thread there, find a new tail. There we go. So build up a little bit more. Have a look at my toppings. That one could do. See what we got. Looks nice. Let's add that one instead. Mixing the thread a bit more, and then just tie it in properly. Once again, the fiber. So I prepared this one, I'm just gonna cut it. And then of course, add it on top of each other. There we go. Just gonna remove and get another fiber there. So So, looks good. So I'm just gonna wax the thread. And tie the bunch in, so to say. Using the material to build up the body a bit. Secured. So I'm just gonna use some silk to even up, since the next step is ostrich curl, and then we have embossed tinsel silver. So I'm just gonna prepare, tying that one in first. It's not going to be in the way. They kinda are in the way. So, wax thread. Going back again. Time for the ostrich curl then. Short, tight wraps. Waxing the thread before tying in the ostrich thread. So, let's see how it will turn out then. There we are. Few wraps. We can remove it. I think I take it from here. Just using this silver silk to even out the body. Just gonna make sure so we can see properly. Not that long, but somewhere there. Just gonna get the thread there so I can tie it in. Then we're going back and start with the embossed silver tinsel. I might need to add more silk to prepare. So half of the fly is somewhere there. I think it will be okay, but still the first half of the fly will be oval tinsel, and that's thicker than the embossed one. So let's see what I got. Some more silver silk lying on my desk. So let's use that one. There we go. It's a lovely hook to tie on. This is a handmade hook from Graham Kelly. Let's go back. Here we have the embossed tinsel. We need to be careful so we don't break it. Just gonna read the pattern to make sure I don't forget any step. It's been a while since I did the Rosy Dawn. Looks like the wax on my finger transferred back to the embossed. That's not really nice. That's not nice at all. So let's change that. You don't want to have black wax on your embossed silver tinsel. Terrible. So new tinsel. It's broken. So I think, thinking out loud, I might use my gloves. Nearly there. Just gonna have a look on the other side. Looks okay. I just noticed something, so we're gonna change. Good. I'm pleased with that. So I just remove the insert on the leftover part, then tie it in. Looks good from both sides. Then we're gonna have my magenta hackle. Thank you. go. So I'm just gonna add some black wax as well. So, I'm just folding the hackle backwards. There we have a lump of magenta. So, just tying it in. The bonus with you, I think with the tinsel it's gonna be quite equal in width. So I'm not gonna build up the body, I'm just gonna add the tinsel. And that's gold oval tinsel. Just remove a bit of the gold. Then you secure it properly. That we're gonna leave. Don't forget to look on both sides. Yep. think we're gonna leave it there. Since we're gonna have magenta hackle and blue one. And since that eating a bit of the hook length, I don't really do it 50-50 in size. Put the thread away. This hackle is a little bit longer. Just pull the feather backwards. I'm trying not to take too much space forward. And I think that's sufficient since we need to have the blue as well. So waxing the thread and then tie in the blue hackle in the front. Pale blue. Few reps just to make the blue visible. That would be sufficient. Let's cut the leftover. We have room for the rest of the fly. So I'm going to wax the thread and build up a little bit here. And then we're going to add the middle wing, the tippet, then the wing, and a few toppings, two to three toppings, I think, depending on the look. So I'm going to find those materials and we're going to start the video after. Time to mount the middle wing. I did find two feathers that is quite equal. And I don't need to remove any material, so I'm just going to tie them in as they are. And I'm going to tie them in long so they match in the back. So I'm just going to see how it looks. Somewhere like that. I'm just gonna leave room from the front tackle. I just split it on the top. Something like that. And have a look. Tie it in. It will do fine. I just need to build up a bit between the front and the hackle. Yeah, that will be good. And I need my glasses, otherwise I can't see anything. To learn to remember that. I think we're almost there. So plenty of wax. Still a little bit off. So let me see. And yeah. Now it's spot on, almost, just move it a little bit, now it's spot on. That one is going to press down a bit when the wing is coming. So the task now is to varnish to make sure it stays in place. Also try to move some fibers. Så, där är vi är. Let's try to mount the wing then. That's the next step. I'm just gonna shorten it a bit. I have done quite a thin wing. Not much materials. Let me see if I can. It's gonna slide. The golden crescent is a bit short. Let me see if I can. Now, one fiber is still not going in. Is it the whole section? Try to redo that. Need to do the wing a bit shorter. Go to the golden pheasant. Got the grip. They're gonna contact with everything else. Almost two fibers. Maybe I can just remove them. One, two, and the rest out with me. Thank God. There we are. Looks good. The wing is just a bit offset. I think we manage. Let's give it a try. Relax and the thread a bit. Good. So now we're talking Yeezy on the sides and 2 or 3 toppings. Let me get some Yeezy. It's a split, but I like the color, so let's go with that. It's okay. So it's gone. Sometimes I put some varnish on it. Let me see. I can do that. As you see, it's split. So I just put it on the back side. Let it dry a bit. It's a dry varnish anyhow. And there we are. So now it's not a split anymore. Just a little bit of varnish on top of it. Make sure it stays there. And then this one, I guess I'm gonna measure. So it's an equal size or equal length. Looks good. So now I'm just gonna select a few toppings and then we start the video again. So, topping time. Gonna see how many toppings we're gonna use. Not decided yet, I prepared three. Here's topping number one. First topping on. I'm gonna varnish that and then wait a little bit before attaching the second one. I think I will go with only two toppings. So last one is prepared. Just gonna cut the fiber I don't like. There we are. Then shorten it. There we are. So, topping number two. And I want to have it straight on the top. There we are. Straight on top of the other one. Something like that. So I'm just gonna varnish, finish off the head, take a picture, and that's basically it. So that's how you tie the Rosedawn. A nice pattern. I think I will tie a few on a fishing hook. Just give it a try during the summer. Might work, who knows? Yeah, that's basically it for today. Stay safe and take care, and see you in the next video. Bye.
Oh baby, I love your madness. It's so incredibly